Our respected Minister for State of State for External Affairs and my dear friend Dr. Rajkumar Ranjan Singh ji, our Ambassador of the European Union to India and Bhutan, Mr. Ugo Astuto, all the dignitaries who are present on the dais and off the dais, all our friends who have joined us from different parts of the country and also the globe, and all my dear friends who have come here to be part of this very special and a very, very important program. At the very outset, I would like to apologize. Originally, I was not supposed to be here in this program, but in the afternoon, I was told that I should attend, and I had many, many programs in my schedule, and hence I had to shift my schedule as was mentioned, but I still could not save 30 minutes. So I apologize. I know time is very, very important and the most important resource, so we should not waste it. But I am very thankful to all of you for having patiently waited for me. I will not take much time simply because actually I'm not very prepared also, because I was told at the last moment that I will have to be here. But of course, I have been following up on what is happening. And at the very outset, I would like to really thank our Honorable Prime Minister, the Government of India in terms of the Ministry of External Affairs, the Honorable Minister who's present out here, our officials from the EU, our Ambassador, for having taken this very, very important step. And when I was listening to our respected DG's speech and the entire mindset that is there in the way they're approaching this entire mission that they're having is something that is very, very encouraging. Because the entire model, as mentioned, is shifting from a development-based model to a partnership-based model. And I think that's really critical. Because when you talk of a partnership, it means much more. And obviously, it requires a lot of trust. It requires a lot of investment. It requires a lot of commitment. It requires respect. It requires being realistic. So I'm very happy, because I personally also am a person who always believes that it is more important to build up long-term partnerships than just simply look at business and development alone. So with that note, it's really very, very encouraging to see that for the first time, a meeting at this level is taking place in the Northeast. The Honorable Prime Minister, Shri Narendra Modi ji, has been a person who has been very, very focused on the Northeast part of India. And he's always stressed that every state must be developing for India to develop and to change. And I think this thought process has driven this entire way in which we are today approaching the policy at the national level, and even here at the regional level and the level of our state. And really, that is what it is at the crux of what we're doing today. When you talk of the Northeast part of India, of course, it is has many, many challenges. We are a region which has huge opportunities. And we are a region that has got a very, very mixed and, of course, different cultural backgrounds and a very diverse society. We have a lot of resources out here. And obviously, the fact that we are 98% connected with other countries is in itself a challenge, but a huge opportunity if you look at it in the long run, if we do things well. And this is where I think the entire partnership between EU, India, and of course, the Northeast states, and of course, the rest of the country comes into play. I, for one, am a very, very strong proponent of this concept. And I've been speaking about this since my first term as Chief Minister, from the time I met Honorable Prime Minister for the first time and proposed to him nothing but connectivity and partnership with Bangladesh when it comes to me. In the sense, me, I mean my state. When it comes, so we have been focusing on Bangladesh, and I have been stressing on this that for the rest of the country, it is always Act East, but when it comes for Meghalaya, it is Act South. And hence, I have been always advocating that whenever we come out with any kind of policy or program, when we're going to come out with a more specific and a program that's going to be more practical in nature, you know, we need to ensure that I spoke about this in the Niti Aayog meeting also last time with the Honorable Prime Minister there, that we need to create different zones. A zone approach is very important. Now, I explained this in Niti Aayog also, that if Meghalaya has to work with a long-term plan with Bangladesh, then the regions of the northwestern part of Meghalaya, which is towards Dhubri and Gwalpara, and the region with West Bengal and Assam and Meghalaya must come together and must have a regional or a zonal policy to work with that part of Bangladesh, because the resources, the opportunities are different, the challenges are different in that zone. And so a zone-based policy is going to be very critical if we really want to make things happen. I mean, we are all, been in governance for a long time. We know that everything has to be specific to the requirements of a region. So similarly, when it comes to Tripura and Mizoram and the entire Chittagong belt, the entire, and Cox's Bazar and all those, the entire approach for the strategy that's going to be done by Government of India, EU, or NEC or any other organization will have to be, again, tailor-made to those zones. So my appeal, I think, today would be that while we start this journey, I think it'll be important for us to be able to identify certain important zones where we can start the partnership moving forward. I think it's important to be able to look at some few low-hanging fruits and make real steps forward. So like, if we try to do too many things, then I think we may not be able to move forward. I'm nobody to speak for everybody out here, but I personally believe that that's the way to move forward in. From Meghalaya point of view, we have been very, very clear. I have been always stressing with Honorable Prime Minister that our linkage, our physical road linkage with Bangladesh is very crucial for us. And I've been stressing on this link between Shillong, Guwahati, Shillong, Dauki, Tamabil, and all the way through Silhet down to Chittagong, which was obviously our trade route even 200 years back. So we must push it, and obviously I'm thankful to Government of India that now the double laning and hopefully four laning and soon for the road to Dauki will take place, because this we feel strongly is going to be in a huge trade route in the next 50 to 100 years to 200 years time. What it was 200 years back, we expect that it will happen the next 200 years. So I think that kind of a goal and strategy is required. So this is one very, very important link that we have been looking at. Another very important link we've been looking at is a complete parallel road. I'm sorry, I don't have a presentation, but if you were to imagine the map of Northeast and a parallel road to the National Highway 37, which runs all the way from your Bakshirhat entry and goes into Gwalpara and then comes through Guwahati and then goes into Nagaland and then to Manipur and other states. So if there's a parallel road to that, then in the long run, I think that's a very, very parallel road across the Bangladesh-India border, connecting the two points of West Bengal Hilly to Mahendraganj in Meghalaya. This could be a real big game changer in the long run for the economic progress, because this would cut the time that takes for Tripura or Mizoram to reach the rest of India by almost close to maybe, 1,000 kilometers. So that's like saving about 15 to 20 hours to 25 hours. And obviously that's a lot of savings. So I think it's important to then focus on these few critical infrastructural developments that require. Number three, from my point of view, I feel that this entire aspect of the cable, submarine cable connection is something that's very important. I think, I don't know how long it will take, but I was just having a review of my IT policy and program just before this meeting, and we were discussing about this exact issue. And we're having some challenges in that, but I hope that soon we'll be able to get these submarine cables into the rest of the Northeast also, because as far as I know, I think Tripura has managed to get it, but some rates issues are there, which is again causing some commercial issues. But I think this is one area that is going to be very, very important from Meghalaya's point of view, because Meghalaya is now slowly we are moving into investing a lot in IT. We have a very strong human resource, which is as of now supplying the services in different parts of the country. And we feel that we can cut the cost by bringing back the human resource and creating the infrastructure here and creating the ecosystem, more importantly, and be able to get the benefit of the IT sector for us in the state of Meghalaya also. So this is one area that is something that we are very keen to work on, and I'm sure it will be something will be positive. Power is, of course, a sector which has been a big challenge for our state. We have always relied on clean energy. So all our production is clean energy, but then when it doesn't rain, then it becomes very difficult for us. So it is forcing us to now think out of the box and take extreme steps. And of course, it's something that we need to realize that weather patterns are changing. Well, sometimes we get heavy rainfall, sometimes we don't see the rainfall for a very long time. So in all these challenges, we're very happy that finally government of India has approved the coal mining in the state, which was banned about 7, 8, 9 years back. And we fought the case in Supreme Court, we won the case, and now the policies and systems have been put in place to allow us to once again mine the coals out here. But of course, I know that that's not part of the sustainable program, but nonetheless, for energy security for the state, there is a basic load capacity which is required, and hence a mix of the energy is required. So I'm sure that all those areas will have to be worked out, but that's something that we are very, very keen on working. On a larger scale, as a state, we have been working with a large number of international agencies. Meghalaya is one of the higher or I should say, I won't say better performing, it's not fair to say that, but we have been one of the more active states that has taken a large number of externally aided projects, and we have been able to really implement them well, which has in fact allowed us to take even more. We are facing some challenges with that with Government of India. We're trying to work that out, but point being that we have really started working with agencies. And why this meeting is a really positive step forward for us, is because what happens with these partnerships, which a lot of people don't realize it, but it raises the level of professionalism and the work, the way you work. You see, you are, as a state government, used to a certain way of working, and suddenly you're exposed to a different standard that allows you to build up the capacity, as was being mentioned by so many people. And I think this capacity building which is there, the capacity to absorb investment, the capacity to spend the money that you get, I mean, it's a big challenge. And states in the Northeast are not able to do it. Today, we have been showing excellent performance, I should say, whether it is all Government of India schemes, and even in Jal Jeevan Mission, which was mentioned earlier by Ambassador, Honorable Ambassador, that in Jal Jeevan Mission, we are really absorbing the maximum amount that's possible. And Government of India has been so kind that they have now sanctioned in one single year, they've sanctioned about 3,500 plus crores of schemes for Meghalaya to spend, because they've seen the capacity that we have had. So this capacity building and this partnership of learning through the innovation that you have done through process and through technology both, is something I think we need to be able to pass on to the states. And I think that's something that is very crucial. We don't realize the importance of that as political leaders sometimes, but it is truly, truly important for us, because that's when we really are seeing the changes that are taking place. So I really look forward to all these areas of partnership. Things don't happen in a single day. So we need to realize that the consistency has to be there. We should not just simply leave it with a program here. I don't believe that it always has to be a big thing. You see, we start with small things. It doesn't matter. We start with one person. We start the partnership or relationship with one day. But the idea is to take it, move it forward, find a common interest to goal or a common, you know, target or a vision that you have. And that's what's going to make us drive forward. So I hope that through the discussions you have, we're able to find that common ground, because that is what's going to make us sure, make sure that we're going to move from one person to two, and then we'll finally be able to cover the entire region. You know, we start with one village maybe, but then we'll cover the entire state. But we need to ensure that we start. We need to ensure that it may be small, but we continue, be consistent, and we are able to ensure that this partnership has true meaning, which means we must have trust, we must have commitment, we must have respect, we must be realistic in our targets, there must be mutual gain for everybody. I think these values are always there, as has been said by so many people who have spoken before me. But as I said, I am very, very excited about this partnership and this entire process that has started. And as a government, this is our second term, and this is the first year of our second term as a government. So I'm very hopeful and very happy that in the future we'll be able to, I think I was speaking too long, maybe that's why this, it's like an indication. Maybe the organizers did it, I don't know. So basically this entire process is something, as I said, which is exciting for me, and I really look forward to it. And I can assure you that from my side, there will be full commitment and full support to all the efforts that are made to take this partnership forward. And once again, I would like to thank the Honorable Prime Minister for his leadership, his vision, and his commitment to the region and to the state of Meghalaya. And of course, I would like to thank all the officials of the European Union and the entire EU-India Global Gateway conference that we're having. And I wish this program and the future programs the very best. Kublai Shibun, Mutela, thank you, and Jai Hind.